Welcome back to this video lecture series on programming questions for placement preparation. So today the problem we're going to see is called as implement stack as a queue. So whenever we are actually learning about stack and queue, this is a very popular and general question, and it is also important whenever we see that it's asked quite frequently in placement experiences. So the problem will be given a task to create a stack and implement its operations, like show its contents. We need to implement the stack with the help of queue. Okay, so how to do that? Let's have a look at the approach. So what we basically need here is we basically need two queues. Let's say Q1 and Q2. The aim for this approach will be to keep the pop operation of a queue and the front operation, or which will return the the element at front of the queue to be returned, that these two operations needs to be kept unchanged. So we will not alter anything, any kind of functionality for these two functions. What we will do to implement stack using these queues is that we are going to make push operation costly. So in push operations, first, when an element is to be pushed, it is pushed to the stack Q2, and then we run a loop while the queue Q1 is not empty. And while this loop continues, what we are going to do, we are going to pop all the elements of Q1 and append it to the Q2, and then we swap the two queues Q1 and Q2, because for all the other functions we will be using the Q1 queue as the reference queue. So whenever an alteration is being done, we will swap these two queues in the push operations. So after that, we use queue to invoke pop or top operation, which will yield the result that is expected for a stack. So let's jump on to the programming part and let's see how we can do it. So I have opened this IDE, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a class and I'm going to name it stack. So here what I want is that whenever I make any object of stack and try to do something with the stack, I want only the operations on stack to be public for those objects. So I'm going to make two members private for this class. The first one is the size of the stack, so I'll name it size, and the other one are the two queues that we are going to use, the kind of element, the type of data actually the queue is going to store will be int. And I'm going to take two queues here, Q1 and Q2. Now all the function definitions will be there, so I'm making it public. So first I'll define the constructor. So whenever this constructor is called, what it will do, it will initialize the size with 0. So the stack is empty now. Then we will implement the push operation. So the return type will be void, the name is push, and here the element to be pushed will be given as an argument. So what we're going to do, we're going to first increment the size, then we're going to push this element to the stack queue. Then I'm going to run a loop. This is the steps in which we are making the push operation costly. While Q1, sorry, I'm going to use another bracket here. While Q1 is not empty, so not Q1 dot empty. What we are going to do is Q2 dot push Q1 dot front and pop it. So Q1 dot pop. Right, now swap it. So for that I'm going to use another Q here. Again, type will be integer. Let's name it Q. So I'm going to store this Q1 here. Then in this Q1 I'll be assigning the Q2 and lastly Q2 will hold the queue. So it's the swapping of these two queues. Now let us define the pop operation. No arguments to be passed here. So if we see that Q1 will be the reference queue, as I told you earlier. If we see that the Q1 is empty, then we'll return nothing, just return. Otherwise, what we do this Q1.pop. Then the top of the stack operation, so top, we are going to return the front of the Q1 queue. So first I'm going to check that if Q1.empty is true, then return -1. Otherwise, okay, so this is not going to be top actually, it's going to be int. Otherwise return q1.front and q1.pop. Lastly, we can actually get another function, that is get size of the stack. So it will return the current size, so return size. Okay, also one thing, whenever you are popping actually, what we are going to do is the size will be decremented. Okay, so now in the main function, let me create an object of this stack class. Then I'm going to use this push operation, and I'll first push 3 to the stack, and then I'm going to copy this twice. So first I'll push 3, then 2, and lastly 1. So here I'm going to first get the size of the stack, so size of stack, this is going to be s dot get size, another n line. Now here I'm going to get the top, so top of the stack. So I'm going to again do a c out top of the stack. This will be s dot top end line. Now I'm going to do pop, let's say twice. And then again I'm going to get the top of the stack, so let me just copy it. And I'll say now top of the stack, and then again I'm going to pop this, and again lastly I'm going to get the size of the stack. So here, right, so let's now run this code. Okay, so the output is here. See, firstly, when just after creating the stack, the size of the stack would be 0, right? And after doing 3 push operations, you would expect 1 to be at top of the stack. Yes, it is. Then after 2 pop operation, we would expect 3 to be on the top of the stack. Yes, it is. And after popping 3, there will be no elements in the stack, so size of the stack will be 0. So this has been done properly, in the sense we tried to implement the stack operations with the help of queues, and we did it efficiently. Thank you for staying with us. See you next time.